नाउ चिल्ड्रन क्वेश्चन नंबर 49 पेज नंबर पेज नंबर 3.142 द क्वेश्चन सेज डब्ल्यू एंड आर पार्टनर्स इन अ फर्म शेयरिंग प्रॉफिट्स इन द रेशियो ऑफ 3:2 द बैलेंस शीट एज ऑन 31 मार्च 2019 वॉज एज फॉलोज बैलेंस शीट ऑफ डब्ल्यू एंड आर एज ऑन 31/3/2019 So over here on the liabilities side, creditors are given 20,000. Provision for bad debts is given 2,000. Instead of subtracting it from the debtors, it has been shown in the liability side. This is also a way of presentation of provision for bad and doubtful debts. Outstanding salary is 3,000. General reserve is 5,000. Capitals of W is 60,000. R is 40,000. Total capital comes to 1,00,000. Total of the liability side is 1,30,000. On the asset side, cash account is 12,000, debtors are 18,000, stock is 20,000, furniture is 40,000, plant and machinery is 40,000. Total is 1,30,000. On the above dates, he was admitted for 1/6 share in the profits of the profits on the following terms. Number 1, C will bring rupees 30,000 as his capital and rupees 10,000 for his share of goodwill premium, half of which will be withdrawn by W&R. Half of the goodwill will be withdrawn by W&R. Then number 2, debtors rupees 1,500 will be written off as bad debts and a provision of 5% will be created for bad and doubtful debts. So first, the bad debts will be subtracted. Whatever are the debtors left after subtracting bad debts, 5% on that will be created as provision for bad and doubtful debts. Outstanding salaries will be paid off. A stock will be depreciated by 10%, furniture by 500, and plant and machinery by 8%. Investments rupees 2,500 not mentioned in the balance sheet were to be taken into account. A creditor of rupees 2,100 not recorded in the books was to be taken into account. So a past necessary journal entries for the above transactions in the books of the firm on C's admission. So I am not passing the journal entries in this question. I am doing this question as where all the 9 steps will be taken into consideration. Tomorrow I will do again this question by just passing the journal entries. It's clear? So see question number 49, page 3.142. W, R and C, they are partners and they were sharing, in W and R were partners and they were sharing profits in the ratio 3:2. C was admitted for 1/6 share. We will calculate the total share of the firm which will come to 1, that is 3/2 + 2/5, 1, and from this we will subtract the new partner's share. So the remaining share is 5/6, and this 5/6 will be distributed among the old partners in the old profit sharing ratio. Therefore, that will become the new profit sharing ratio. So the new profit sharing ratio for W will be 15/30 and for R will be 10/30. Now in case of C, C is coming for 1/6 share. To make the denominator equal to 30, 6 into 5 is equal to 30 and 5 by 30. Now we will calculate the sacrificing ratio. For W, 3/5 was the old ratio, minus 15/30, it comes to 3/30. For R, it was 2/5 old ratio and the new ratio is 10/30. So 2/30 is the new, is the sacrificing ratio of R. So their sacrificing ratio is 3:2. Now the treatment of goodwill. It is given that C is bringing 30,000 as his capital and 10,000 for his share of goodwill. So cash account. Why cash has been taken? Because in the balance sheet, cash is mentioned. So cash account debit 40,000 to C's capital account 30,000 to premium for goodwill account 10,000. Now premium for goodwill account debit 10,000 because it is to be distributed among the partners. Here it is coming, it is an income for the firm, therefore it has been credited. Now it will be closed and the partner's capital accounts will be paid in sacrificing ratio. So to W's capital account, 10,000 divided by 5 into 3 is 6,000. To R's capital account, 10,000 divided by 2 divided by 5 into 2 is equal to 4,000. Now half of the amount has been withdrawn by the partners. So W's capital account will be debited rupees 3,000. Whatever has been credited to W, half of that amount will be withdrawn. 6,000 ka half hua 3,000 and 4,000 ka half hua 2,000. R's capital account will be debited by rupees 2,000. And this amount has been withdrawn in cash, so cash account will be credited rupees 5,000 because the money is going out. Now the treatment of general reserve. The general reserve is the part of the profit that has been kept for future contingency, to meet out future emergencies or contingencies, and that part of the profit was the profit that has been earned by the firm under W&R, old partners. So it will be distributed among the old partners. General reserve given in the balance sheet is 5,000 and it will be deleted from the books. So general reserve account will be debited because it is shown on the liability side, and the liability side accounts have a credit balance. To reduce them, we will debit that particular account. Here general reserve account will be debited rupees 5,000. W's capital account will be credited rupees 3,000 and R's capital account will be credited by rupees 2,000. So this will be the general entry. Now we will prepare the revaluation account. So see, in the revaluation account it is given that debtors rupees 1,500 will be written off as bad debts. Bad debts reduces our debtor. Reduction in debtor means that our asset is declining. Decline in the asset is debited to bad debts 1,500. It's clear. Then it is given and a provision of 5% will be created for bad and doubtful debts. So over here we will prepare a working note. We will write by provision for bad and doubtful debts, and we will see working note number 1. So here working note. Debtors as per balance sheet, 18,000 was the amount of the debtors. First we will subtract less bad debts, 1,500. Balance left is 16,500. Now we will subtract the provision for bad and doubtful debts at the rate 5%, 16,500 into 5 by 100 is equal to 825. So the balance left is 15,675. It's clear. Now your provision for bad debts as per the balance sheet is 2,000 and the new provision is 825. It means the old provision of 2,000 has reduced to 825. So this amount of provision for bad debts, 1,175, will be written off from the book. So it will be, provisions are liabilities, either they are subtracted from the debtors on the asset side of the balance sheet or shown on the liability side of the balance sheet as shown in this question. They are liabilities, therefore a liability is to be declined by rupees 1,175. So decline in the value of the liability is credited. 1,175 will be credited for provision for bad and doubtful debts. Then the other thing, outstanding salary will be paid off. The outstanding salary given in the balance sheet will be paid off. So another liability is going to decline. So we will credit it by outstanding salaries 3,000. Then it is given stock will be depreciated by 10%. Depreciation will reduce the value of the asset. So to stock, the value of stock given in the balance sheet is 20,000. 10% of 20,000 is 2,000. To furniture, अमाउंट ऑफ दैट फर्नीचर बाय 500, बाय 500 मीन्स सिर्फ 500 रुपए से ही कम होगा, सो ओनली 500 रुपीज विल बी टेकन. टू प्लांट एंड मशीनरी एंड इट इज गिवन एंड प्लांट एंड मशीनरी बाय 8%. सो द अमाउंट ऑफ प्लांट एंड मशीनरी गिवन इन द बैलेंस शीट इज 40,000, 8% ऑफ 40,000 इज 3,200. Our plant and machinery will reduce by rupees 3,200 because depreciation has been charged on it at the rate 8%. Then it is given investments rupees 2,500 not mentioned in the balance sheet were to be taken into account. Investments are assets and these assets were not given in the balance sheet and they are to be accounted for. So our asset will increase in form of investments rupees 2,500. Increase in asset is credited to revaluation account. Then it is given a creditor of rupees 2,100 not recorded in the books was to be taken into account. A creditor which has not been shown in the book is to be accounted for. Means our creditors are going to increase. Our liability is going to increase. Therefore, unrecorded creditors will be credited to revaluation account. We will balance the revaluation account. The debit side total is 9,300 and the total of the credit side is short by rupees 2,625. So this is the loss on revaluation account. And this loss will be distributed among the partners in their old profit sharing ratio, that is also 3:2. So 2,625 divided by 5 into 3, 1,575. 625 divided by 5 into 2, 1050. It's clear? Now the